Well, that's the moon. That's
still there.
It is such a beautiful night here. Almost a full moon. Probably perfect weather. Still, the humidity, you say, is causing a little bit of problem with some of the brass.
Yeah, it takes the edge off the sound. Projection.
But what a night and what a crowd here at Pride of Indiana, the sixth one from Bill Armstrong Stadium on the campus of Indiana University. I'm Keith Klein, and with me, Don Pescioni, Executive Director of Drum Corps International. Don, how good is Drum Corps International? How's the program doing? What do you need more of?
We need more national exposure, and that's our focus for the rest of the 80s. They get some national attention. We're the best kept secret in North America.
I have a totally different view of this, perhaps, than you do, but when I look at these young people, and I see the effort that they put into this, and I start to go around to the practices and see the repetitiveness of the things that they do, and know that in some cases they've started back in November getting ready for what is going on here tonight, I don't think an outsider can understand what these young people are going through to be in these corps.
It's very difficult to explain. First of all, nobody would believe that a young person would spend that much time on a single thing. The other thing is that the kids are so focused and so dedicated to this project that they'll spend 18 hours a day perfecting their show. In fact, it's not uncommon for them to spend 12 hours a day once the season begins perfecting their program.
The Velvet Knights are getting set up out there now, but I want to give a message to a youngster that might know music, to parents and grandparents and anyone that cares for young people who have some musical ability, and they don't have to be real good because the choir will teach them all of the stuff they need to know. If you have never thought about being in a drum corps, think about it. Find one near you and get in it, because there is nothing but growth ahead for a youngster that gets involved in this activity.
You betcha. Don't be intimidated.
And they have
these
fun.
Are just
Look
kids.
At these kids.
Yeah.
This is fun to do.
It's a little disorganized, a little embarrassing at times, but these kids are having a great time, as you can see.
Where can they go to find out about core activity?
Well, they can call our office if they want to find a group closest to them. Our office is in Lombard, Illinois, Drum Corps International. And or they can talk, their local band director would know where they're located.
Okay. If you're listening now and you didn't catch where to call, call WTIU. We'll tell you how to get a hold of Don Pescioni.
Super.
And we're in the phone book. Call us. We'll tell you how to get a hold of Don. You can find out where there's a corps near you. We want to talk about this corps. This is kind of the comic corps of this show. There are other shows, other corps that do fun shows.
Let's just say they're laid back. Not comic.
They're California.
They're laid back, yeah.
What they're doing, Don, is they're taking all the California cliches that us Midwesterners think Californians are, and they're capitalizing on it.
That's true. The thing that's different about this group this year than in prior years and in the past is that they're pulling this show off because they have an incredible percussion section, and they're very, very tight arrangements and a quality brass section. And they are scoring very high.
Their show is the surfer show, so to speak. Those kids, yes, are wearing red Converse tennis shoes. They will put on red baseball hats.
Baseball caps, yeah.
There will be a section in there where the girls will put on swim fins.
That's right.
You will see people with lawn chairs and picnic baskets. There are some of the shoes.
And
they do some neat things in marching with those shoes. It's not anywhere near traditional marching.
We don't talk about the technique, though.
But they have a great time.
They have a great time. The audience has a great time because the performers are having a great time. They don't take themselves too seriously, but you can bet that they're looking at the point score at the end of the show. What you might see may not indicate that, but they're really pushing for top spots this year.
Well, if it's as much fun for the audience as it has been for me when I've seen this group, as they seem to have when they do it, it's going to be a good show. Let's go down to Joe Bruno and hear the introduction of the Velvet Knights.
A musical mystery tour in L.A., to Chinatown, to Brazil, to an African medley, and back to a California medley, all in tuxedos and tennis shoes. None other than our next unit, from Anaheim, California, the Velvet Knights. Are the judges ready? Drum Major Ryan Turner, is your corps ready?
Corps check center!
I guess that's a yes. Velvet Knights, you may take the field for competition.
Ready, front!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Don, I don't know what a judge would say about this, but when he gets the crowd on his feet and they enjoy it this much, I guess, in a sense, the scores don't mean it. Look at him leave. Now, the crowd loves it.
Yeah, they seem like they're the new crowd favorite.
The crowds love it, but what about the judges?
Well, they've got some work to do going into championship. There's no question of that, but boy, they did project, thick air or not. They had a big, tight sound, and they had good contrast, excellent balance. And Bobby Hoffman of Bridgman fame is taking over their choreography, and he's done a heck of a job in putting together the visual show. And the kids are having a great time, and the audience is feeling that. And they're sharing. It's wonderful. It's just absolutely phenomenal.
What's it do to a core when the audience picks up like that and starts to applaud and cheer and yell during the show, way before it's over?
Well, you know, that's what the whole thing's about. When you get at this level in this league, you can practice until you're blue in the face. The thing that makes the difference in communication is how well the kids respond. And the kids are going to respond from the audience. They feed off of one another. And all those things they've been taught will now start to be what we call performed.
They become believers.
You betcha.
Now, the group that is going to be coming in when the Velvet Knights leave, you can see the Velvet Knights lined up, ready to leave. There's the Santa Clara Vanguard. These are about as two a contrasting cores as you could possibly want to see, yet we are about to see what could be a world champion.
You bet. What we just saw was Broadway on a football field, and as Dean Webb say, we're about to see the opera on a football field. You have contrast in style, you have contrast in tradition, and you are about to see one of the classiest acts in our activity.
We should point out that as the Velvet Knights leave, they're passing in front of several hundred high school bandsmen who kind of feel for them. Like, if I was out there, I would want that kind of response. So you're hearing the residual part of the Velvet Knight show as they leave.
If I were a parent, I'd make sure I knew where my kid was, because like in the old days with the circus, I think they might follow him out of town.
I'll tell you, they make it look like fun. But now, this show that's setting up on the field, the Santa Clara Vanguard, day and night in terms of approach, but in terms of what to expect, the audience here is about to see the best show that can be seen if they're on.
This show is the pace setter for the season. It's the favorite going into championship. It is a classy show. It's a building of their program from last year, and they are ready. This is the most sophisticated program we've seen in drum corps for a good long time. An entirely different approach, more theatrical than traditional.
Do judges get puritanical sometimes and say, I want a classical show, what Dean Webb calls this, the opera of drum corps, and I don't want that make fun of music kind of approach of Velvet Knights?
Well, they're two different idioms, and they're not compared to one another. They're compared for what they are against what they are. Santa Clara's compared to what they are against what they've been. The fear of trying something new like Santa Clara is doing is that they may not, the judges we're speaking of now, compare it against the standards that Santa Clara has set within this idiom, but they may compare it against the opera, and that's not quite fair. However, as they get better and polish their technique and develop their better communication, you may be able to compare it.
What we're about to see here in terms of a show for the audience's benefit, how long does it take to get to the point Santa Clara is at tonight, not just for this show, but to be a world-class corps?
Well, this is their 20th season, and they came out of the chute a world-class corps, and they've just built on that program. They've established an incredible identity and have built on that identity and modified that identity each year as the activity changes and evolves. They're a wonderful, wonderful program, and their director, G.R. Royer, is an incredible talent and is a great, great director.
You can see, or you can sense from what's being set up on the field, that there's a Russian theme to all of this. You see the man walking around as the old Russian. You'll see a folk scene in this. You'll see some folk music in it. You'll see Mussorgsky, and you'll see all kinds of Russian theme through this. the music that's going on now is really part of this warm-up, too. It's not the show.
It is the show. It's all part of the show.
Let's go down now to field announcer Joe Bruno.
Every time you heard people talk about this next unit, they were called, yeah, but what about? You see, when people would talk about who they would think could win the world championship, someone would name a car and someone else would say, yeah, but what about our next unit? And the reason is because of their track record. 6 times in the colorful DCI history, number 3 in the world. 4 times number 2 in the world. And unbelievably, 4 times they've won it all. From Santa Clara, California, the Santa Clara Vanguard. Are the judges ready? Drum majors Tim Andrese and Ken Serra, is your corps ready? Santa Clara Vanguard, you may take the field for competition.
Thank you.
class, Don.
What a magnificent performance. Unfortunately, the people in the television audience really can't feel it on this dimension, but I'll tell you, this medium, I mean, this was one wonderful performance.
At the end of the show, I was sitting there thinking, if you had the best stereo you could ever have, and you really felt emotion when you heard emotional music, you would not be able to duplicate that last few moments of the Gates of Kiev as they moved forward and that sound enveloped you. Oh. It's just gorgeous.
There wasn't a hair in my body that was in place. It was all standing at attention and that thing.
And you've seen this.
This is my 38th year. And this drum corps does this to me. I just can't believe it. They're just incredible performers. These kids can play that music, all those tempo changes, and move the way they do. It's incredible. I just can't believe it.
You get thrilled. I get teary-eyed. I get emotional when I see something that good, and I get emotional on two levels. One level is, of course, seeing something that you recognize as class and quality and the best and the top drawer. The other one is an understanding that these are youngsters out there. These are not professional musicians.
You betcha. Look at the way they carry themselves.
Some aren't even in college yet.
No, that's true. That's true.
And to have that poise and that presence and that kind of musicianship, and to look at them, and anyone has got any question at all about what's going on in this country today with young people, if you look at these kind of young people, this is what you want your kids doing.
There's no limit to what young people can do, and I think this is a perfect display of that. This activity personifies the capabilities of young people, whether or not they play musical instruments or not. You can see we have dancers, we have something for just about everybody, and all of these kids excel.